Let's say you have a new WordPress website and just imported a demo for a photography portfolio. But you are not satisfied and you want to replace that demo with another one in the site library of Neve. Or you just want to start over with a fresh installation of WordPress, but you want to keep your themes and plugins in place. Hi everyone, my name is Robert from Themeisle.com and in this video I will show you the fastest and easiest way to reset WordPress to default. Remember that once the reset process ends, you will lose all your content like posts, media files and all the pages you see in the list over here. Here is what you need to do. Install and activate the WP Reset plugin, navigate to Tools, then click on WP Reset. Scroll down until you see the field that says Type in Reset. You have three options above. The first one is to reactivate the current theme, reactivate the WP Reset plugin, and all currently active plugins too. I usually keep all these checkboxes clear when I use WordPress for testing, but you can keep your theme and plugins active if you want that. So, to reset WordPress to default, type in Reset over here and then click on Reset WordPress. There is a last warning pop-up showing on the screen, which asks if you are sure you want to reset the site. You need to click on the red button to proceed. It is your last chance to cancel everything. Once you click on that red button, the resetting process starts immediately, and there is no way back. The only way back is to have a working backup which you can restore immediately. If you go to the All Posts now, you can see only the default Hello World article, which comes with every new installation of WordPress, and there is nothing in the media library. All pages are gone now, and you can see only the privacy policy page and the sample page. Themes and plugins are there, but deactivated, so you can reactivate Neve, for example, and import a new demo. If you want the tattoo demo, for example, click Preview and then Import. Choose if you want to import the content, which means that all images and text on these pages will be imported during the process. If the customizer is on over here, you'll import settings like color, typography, header, and so on. The widgets are what you see on the sidebar of your blog. You have widgets on single posts and pages, and in the footer area too. If you have an older WordPress website with custom content in your widgets area, make sure you deactivate the widgets import to keep your current content untouched. Then you can click on Import and enjoy your new website. Now you can start to customize everything with Elementor and transform it into a unique project. That's it. Have questions? Type them in the comment section below and then check out other videos on our channel about WordPress and Themeisle products. If you are new to the channel, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell so you won't miss any future videos we publish. See you in the next one. Cheers.